The tree hare.
The wind is getting stronger! We need to find bigger rocks so the ship doesn't blow away!
Uh-huh. Check it out! There's a good rock for the ballast.
Tig! Let me help you out with that!
Hey, Martick! Why don't you try to find a spring? Or otherwise, our water will run out.
All right. Go heave house.
Hey, Philin! Wake up already! Hey, Philin!
Let him sleep, Milky. We can't fly in this weather. Anyway, when he's sleeping, he's not eating. Let's go. Let's go see. See if we can find some food.
Look there! What's that strange animal?
Ha! Animal. That's a hare. But a lot plumper, and with a long tail, and he's hopping through the trees, with a pouch on his tummy, and there seems to be a hare in his pouch as well.
Oh, I remember. That's called a tree kangaroo. A wallaby. My dad told me all about that animal. And there's even a legend about it.
Once upon a time, there were wild animals with quite long tails. They were called kangaroos. They jumped around the earth, and they carried their babies in pouches. There was a baby kangaroo, and it was called a joey. And the joey couldn't jump very far. But one day he learned that at the top of the very highest cliff, there is a magical wallaby stone, which grants a wish only once every 100 years. So the joey decided to climb all the way up the cliff. It was a long and difficult journey for a little kangaroo, but he managed to climb up the wallaby stone. He made a wish, and afterwards, he began to jump very high and very far, not only on the ground, but also in the trees. They began to call him Little Kangaroo, a tree kangaroo, or a wallaby.
I wish we'd find a magical stone. That's just what we need now. Then we could wish for help, and we could get Lily back home even faster.
Did you hear that, Milky? That cliff over there has a magical stone that grants wishes.
Uh-huh. But where do we find it, Spike?
Hey, that's it. Look over there.
Hup, 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 hup.
Hi there. You're a good jumper. Look what I can do.
Huh. Oh, wow. That was cool. I am Martick. But who are you?
They call me Wallaroo. I'm a tree kangaroo, a wallaby, the best jumper in Australia. Well, soon I'll be the best jumper. Huh. Woohoo!
Jump over here.
Oh!
Back in the pouch!
Back in the pouch! But I can jump all by myself! I'm big now!
You're so lucky. You get to ride in a pouch. I'd like to try riding in a pouch. Even if it were just once.
Huh! I've got an idea! You can quietly jump in the pouch instead of me. Then I can practice on my own. All right?
Spike! Oh, we're never gonna make it up there!
All we need to do is find ourselves some ninny who's gonna show us the way to get up there. Then the magic wallaby stone is gonna get us out of here!
Hooray! Look at me! Freedom! Finally! The most impressive jumper in all of Australia! Hooray!
Hey, Spike, maybe he can help us?
Hey, that's true. He is a good jumper. Hey, yo, what's your name, huh?
I'm Wallaroo. I'm a tree kangaroo.
Listen,
and
kid,
you?
Jumping on trees is for wimps. But if you climb that big rock over there, now that's where it's at, my little friend. But I bet you're too little. There's no way you could do that, could you?
Me? You think I'm too little? Listen, you, I can easily jump up there and show everyone I'm not a baby, especially my mama.
Oh, what are you waiting for then? Come on, kangaroo. Let's go, huh, Wormaroo, or whatever your name is. Come on and show everyone what you can do, man.
Yeah, show us.
Hey, kid, what do you see? Is there a Wallaby Stone up there or something else? You see it?
Wallaroo! Will you please toss the rock down to us?
Hey, buddy! Where did he go?
A Wallaby Stone? It's the highest stone up here. This is the Wallaby Stone. I'm standing on it.
Oh, you don't say. That rock up there is the Wallaby Stone? Oh, come on. Let's go, Milky. We gotta wait for it to warm up and then convince Philin to take us all the way up there.
Hey, what about me? Wait for me.
Just come down the same way you got up there. It's easy. Jump, hop, but we're out of time. We got stuff to do.
Hey!
Bye-bye.
And while you're up there, don't go asking any riddles.
Hold on, but wait for me. Why are you leaving me all alone? Mama!
Joey, wouldn't you like to take a bath?
No.
Oh, you're such a little piggy, aren't you? But you're not my little precious Wallaroo.
No, I'm Martick. I'm sorry, ma'am.
But where is Wallaroo?
He didn't want to ride in the pouch anymore. He's grown up now and wants to jump on his own. So he's out practicing as we speak.
Wallaroo! My Joey! How did he get on the cliff? We must hurry!
Somebody help me! Help me!
It's coming from over there! Somebody needs our help!
Tig! Reset the ballast! Let's untie the ship! Hurry! We need to get up there before the storm starts!
Jump over? Yeah, I can. I can jump. I simply need to calculate the correct distance.
He just has to jump over. He just has to jump
over. Come on! I know you can do it. We all believe in you.
Heave ho!
Hooray!
Hooray!
Good job. You're so good at jumping.
Great work, buddy.
Wallaroo, you gave your mama such a fright. Thank you, everyone, for helping my little Wallaroo.
Mama, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. I won't trick you ever again, I promise.
Mama was so worried, my son. But if you are able to climb that cliff, then that means that you really are big now. So we can start to practice jumping on the great big eucalyptus tree.
I have the best mama in the whole world.
Goodbye, kids.
Goodbye. We'll see you. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you so much, everyone.
Come back soon. We'll jump on the highest eucalyptus tree together.
I want to make a wish!
I want treasure!
I want all the treasure!
I want a ship!
I
want treasure! No, wait! Quiet, everyone! I wish for the great treasure from the monkey tribe! Ready?
Hold.
Okay, I get it, fine. I bet that this is all because of that bouncing tree kangaroo baby. That little baby must have already made a wish.
He went and wasted our wish.
Ugh. Now we're gonna have to wait another 100 years.
We failed.
Let's get out of here.
Hoot hoot, mice, 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 mice.
Oh, they're so creepy.
Oh, so scary.
The earth splits.
Spike! Can we turn back? Spike! All we see is water, no matter where we look.
Don't cry, Melky. The spots and stripes flew somewhere over this way. That means the treasure's gotta be nearby.
But we're already out of food. This is the last berry we have.
That's the last one? Give it to me!
What's going on?
Beautiful
land.
I told you, didn't I? Come on, my feathered friend. There's plenty to eat just up ahead.
Oh, mice.
Happy hunting.
Land, land, beautiful land. Oh, how I missed you, land.
Hold on. Spots and stripes have to be somewhere nearby.
Who are you? You fell right out of the sky. What are you running from?
But running? We're not running. Nope, not running.
You just said spots and stripes have to be somewhere nearby. Who are they? And why are you afraid of them?
Wait, afraid? Us? Oh, why, yes, of course we're afraid. Spots and stripes are, they're horrible monsters. Worse than you. I mean, you're better. They kidnapped our entire family. Everyone. And now they're hunting me and my brother. Right, little bro?
Yeah.
Oh, gosh. Poor little us.
Oh, poor us. Poor us.
Milky?
What's up?
Poor us.
Oh, yeah. Poor us.
Oh, yes. Poor us. Poor miserable little creatures. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
We'll be more than happy to take you in and give you some food. Come along with us. So go on and tell us more about the monsters you spoke of. The spots monster and the stripes monster.
Well, they're blah.
Wow! Big eggs! Do those eggs taste good?
Do they taste good? Are you being serious?
Those eggs are platypus eggs.
Those eggs hold our future children.
No. You misunderstood him, your platypusness. What he meant was that the spots monster and the stripes monster really love delicious eggs for lunch. Yeah, lunch. And dinner as well. And breakfast also.
What? But they wouldn't dare.
Yes, beware the spots and stripes. It would be best if you attack them first.
These monsters are going to regret ever stepping foot near our great village. Right, my platypus friends?
Yeah! We won't let anyone take away our children!
Well, we gotta go! Thanks for your hospitality! Toodles!
Toodles!
Come on, brother! Come on, little girl!
Hey, guys! We need to go on a mission for reconnaissance!
Great idea, Martick!
In the meantime, we'll build a shelter for tonight.
Tig, let's go! Where are you going?
With you, to do reconnaissance.
Martick, you're too young for reconnaissance.
Why don't you go and help the girls?
La 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 la. La 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 la. We're discovering a world of miracles. And we cannot
wait. That's not fair! I want to go on a reconnaissance mission, too! I mean, after all, it was my idea! Cuba, we'll show them. You and me are not little babies. Come on!
I wonder, do you think there are any monsters out here?
Now that I've stretched my legs, I'm ready. I'm ready to fight them!
Hey, is anybody here? Hello? Where is everyone?
Howdy.
How are you?
We flew here.
Hi.
Come on, let us out!
Spots monster and Stripes monster. They fit the description.
They're really small for monsters, though.
Hey, who you calling a monster? Us?
I think they're still children.
Hey, let us go already!
Hey!
It's disappeared! One of the eggs has disappeared!
Did you steal one of our eggs?
We didn't steal anyone's eggs!
They must have hid it! Where is it? Confess!
You're not getting out of that cage until you tell us where the egg is, you monsters.
We didn't steal anybody's eggs.
Cuba, we have to find that egg somehow. But where do we find a missing
hoot,
egg?
Hoot, hoot, mice. Mice.
Whoa, I know him. That silly villain from mice. Our forest. But what's he doing here?
Let's follow him.
Stealing their eggs! What a brilliant idea! Yes, it was! Yes, it was!
I'm a genius!
Now, Spots and Stripes will leave us alone.
It seems like local mice don't want me to find their hiding places.
Well, if you say so, then let's keep flying!
The treasure awaits us.
Of course! It all makes sense now. You keep them here. I'll bring back the ones with the beaks.
Wait, who's over there?
It's Cuba. Get him. He's all alone.
We're gonna get you. Spike, what do we need a boar for?
I guess you're right, huh?
Hey, Billy. Come on, let's move. Get out of here. Hey, we're overloaded. What are you doing? Get out of here, Cuba.
Yeah, go away.
Look, there's your way.
Aha! Get those imposters.
I got it!
Thank you so much, brave Martick and courageous Cuba. You saved our children. Please forgive our rudeness. Your enemies managed to deceive us.
Martens can be like that. But how did they get here?
Can you please tell us exactly where here is? Everything is so strange and so different. And you are all so interesting.
Yeah, well, back where we come from, only the birds have beaks like that.
We're surprised to see you as well. But there's no need to be alarmed. There is an ancient legend that long, long ago, the land was once one. And it was surrounded on all sides by vast oceans. The ancient earth had all kinds of different animals and birds. Some were like you, and some were like us. Yet they all lived together, and nothing ever came between them. But then, disaster struck, and the earth split apart. Parts of the earth floated away on the world's ocean. You floated to the north, and then became Eurasia. While we platypuses stayed on this piece of land, which is called Australia.
So that means this is Australia? What are the martens doing in Australia?
Villain, you keep flying! The treasure's nearby.
Mice!
An old friend.
6, 7, 8, 9.
No, 11, here I'll be found
12,
right away.
13, 14, 15.
This won't work
16,
either.
17,
oh, so where should I hide?
19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25.
And I'm done counting. Ready or not, here I come. All right. Leo, here I come!
Wow, this is a sweet hiding spot. Tig will have to look for me till nightfall.
Leo, there you are. That was so cool. Let's do it again.
Totally.
Leo, where'd you get this nest anyway?
From a tree. Where else?
But what if this nest belongs to somebody?
Well, you know, the nest is empty. And if it's empty, it means it's abandoned.
Leo, Tig, Mappa's waiting.
Yeah, we're coming. Just a second.
Tig, let's just put it away now and come back later for more riding.
All right. Push it this way.
If you don't hurry, I'm gonna leave without you.
Mila, wait for us.
Okay, so today I'm going to tell you quite an amazing story.
Hey-ho! 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 When the wind above the sea waves, when the wind above the sea waves, when the wind above the sea waves starts to storm and rage, we will scare it off with shouts.
Mappa, who's that flying over there? The crows?
You're a crow, Mila. They are eagles.
Easy, easy, children. Don't fight. Those are storks. They are coming back to their nests after the winter.
Hey-ho!
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 We're flying home.
My friend. It's so wonderful to see an old friend when you come back home.
And who is that?
Children, I want you to meet Theodore. An old friend of mine, a stork.
Mr. Theodore, was it a difficult journey?
Well, as they say in the far land of China, the journey to your family nest begins with a single wing stroke. You know what, children? I'm going to tell you the story of the stork.
Go, wow! I'd be happy to hear that, too.
All right, then. Once upon a time, there lived a stork.
Yes, all alone. All by his lonesome in his giant nest. But then the stork decided to find himself a girlfriend. One day, high in the sky, right under the clouds, he saw a beautiful lady. Only it turned out that this beautiful lady is the daughter of the strongest wind, who didn't want to share her with anyone. The wind came down, and pulled the stork's nest apart. But the stork wasn't about to give up. He built a new nest, much stronger than the previous one. And that's when the wind realized that the stork is a worthy fiancé for his daughter, persistent and courageous. Ever since that time, storks come back to their nests every year, and the families they build last for their entire lives.
Mr. Theodore, do you also have a girlfriend?
Well, a stork with a nest has everything. You know what? Come visit me. It's close on the top of that hill.
Tig, I have a bad feeling that the nest we found might have an owner after all.
Really? And who is he?
The nest is gone.
What do you mean, gone?
Completely gone!
Maybe the wind blew it away.
No one could do that! It was the sturdiest nest in the entire taiga! Oh, no. My Theodora's gonna be here any minute. Oh, you haven't seen her angry. That's it, it's all over.
Don't you worry, sir.
We'll help you. Leo and I will find it in no time.
Let's go, Tig.
Leo, where's the nest?
How should I know? It used to be here.
Weird. It couldn't have just disappeared, could it?
Stop. Do you hear that?
That's so awesome! Did you see the shorty fly out? Come on. Let's go. Let's push it up. Come on! Hurry up! Push! Come on, let's go!
Hey, you! Give us back our nest.
Your nest? Hey, Martens, did you hear that?
Oh, yeah.
The Spotty and the Stripey make nests now.
I can't even believe it.
It's not yours or ours, but the nest does have an owner. Give it back.
Right. First, catch us if you can.
We're asking nicely. Give it back.
Hey,
we're gonna do it the rough way!
Good shot! They're so slow.
Tig! We're in so much trouble!
Oh, no. Is this all that's left of my nest?
No, children. You should be ashamed.
We didn't throw it down from the tree. They did.
That's right. They did.
That's a great way to put it.
Mappa, we were just playing hide-and-seek, and then it fell down. I didn't mean to.
And then we just thought that it had no owner.
We are very sorry.
Yeah. We're very sorry. Please forgive us.
Wise men would say that there can only be a wrong path, but never a hopeless situation. But this is the end!
Children.
Mappa Pandiga, we're gonna fix everything.
Oh, listen, guys. I've got an idea.
Leo, is this one nest material?
For the roof? Sure.
And these?
Just perfect. Put them there.
Okay. Right.
Spike, let the Spotty and the Stripey do the work.
That's right. What are we here for?
Stop asking and start collecting.
All right. A little more. Okay, and one more.
Mila, you need to stop. It's already pretty. Tig, call him.
Okay.
Mr. Storm?
Ooh.
It's done. Come and have a look.
Creeks bring more light, and following spring, I also came back. It's such a surprise.
Well then, wanna race? The first one to that bush wins! Come on!
Going on the count of three. One, two,
three!
Hey, wait! That's not fair!
Sorry. Proceeding with collecting a new shipment of cones.
Flying high.
Phew. Almost ready. We just need to reinforce it from inside.
Leo, let's leave it. It's fine like that.
Hi, everyone. Glad to see you.
Oh, hi, Mila. We're off to get more branches. You stay here and keep watch.
I got it.
We've been gathering these branches all day long. If we keep going, the trees will be bare.
I'm guarding the fortress. I'm guarding the fortress. Who am I guarding it from?
All right. The Spotty and the Stripey went away. Hey, get on over here now, Shorty. This is our meadow now, with all its raspberries.
What do you mean it's yours? The meadow is public, and the fortress is ours.
It used to be, but not anymore. Martens, attack! Get her!
No! I'm not afraid of you! Oh, dear me! Yeah! You nailed him, guys! Mila, don't be afraid!
I'm not, you know!
Hold on! The help is coming!
Martens, shoot down that butterfly!
Hey, bush leaguers! You can't get me! Whoa, you missed! Ah, that was close. Try again, guys! Oh, ow! He actually hit me! What? Bees?
Hey, Shorty! Get out of our fortress! Oh, you're all alone now! Go!
She's not alone!
Ah, the spotted one!
This is our fortress!
It used to be, it's not anymore!
So I've been carrying these branches for nothing?
Martens, attack!
Martens, fall back! This is not over yet!
Yeah!
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 That's right!
And that's don't come back! You hear that? I hope you learned your lesson!
And don't try to scare me again!
I can't believe this. We got beaten by the Spotty and the Stripey. Shame on our heads.
Look here. This is Beelze's lair. Well, well, I've got an idea.
Quiet.
Raspberry. Nice, sweet raspberry. Lots of it.
Lots of it.
And then Mila screams, "Attack them!"
Did you see me? I grabbed one of them. Boom! And that was it. The fight was over, and I'm like, don't you come back!
It was awesome!
Leo, we should run!
Scared much? That'll teach you not to get in our way. It's our meadow now, with raspberries and everything.
So, hey, guys, does it mean that our meadow and our fortress, all of that is gone?
Calm down, Mila. We'll get it all back.
Yeah, sure we will. Wait, Leo, did you see it? We're not strong enough. We can't beat Beels.
I think I know someone who can help us.
Dear Mr. Beals, we had a deal that half of the raspberries would be ours.
Okay, okay. We get it. We totally get it. We do. We totally do. We're leaving already. Run!
Oh, no, kids. I'm a bit too old to fight the brown bear.
You are our only chance to beat him. Leo, let's give up and go to the river.
Wait a minute. Mapa Pandiga, so there's no animal in the forest stronger than the brown bear?
Once upon a time, brown bears had no reason to doubt that. There was no animal stronger than them. So the brown bear grew vain and started to abuse his power, doing bad things. But for every power, there's an even stronger power. The spirit of the tiger always has his children's back.
What do we do now? Search for the spirit of Taiga again so he chases Beals away?
No. We'll get him ourselves. Okay. Mila, I need you to distract Beals. And Cuba, sneak up on his right side. You! Tig! Look at who decided to visit us.
Shush! That glutton kicked us out. He promised to share the raspberries with us.
Let me guess, he didn't.
Sure enough!
Okay. Right now, we need to join forces and chase him away.
Well, are you with us?
For sure. We're with you. But we go 50-50 on the raspberries.
Hey, Beals! Go away! This is our fortress! Stop it, Beals! Why are you following me? What do you want? Leave me alone, please!
way, Beals. This is our meadow.
Yeah, that's right. We found it first.
Who do you think you are, destroying our fortress? Go away right now!
Oh, I get it. You want to show me something? You're home. Why don't you go back inside? Oh, I see. There's something blocking it. Don't sting me now! Are you saying thank you?
Help me.
Huh? Mila's in danger! Bees, will you help me? Please?
Throw more! Throw more!
Oh, we ran out of pine cones!
Oh, no!
Yes, he came here to help us. But how did he know?
That's right. Run away. Go on, run faster. The spirit of Taiga's gonna get you.
Bye, bees. Thank you for helping. You go defeat another enemy.
For his valor and outstanding flying, Marty is rewarded
with a delicious raspberry. Ooh, these are good raspberries.
Tig! Try to keep up!
I am keeping up. I wanted to breathe some fresh air. I've heard it's good for your health.
In that case, can you breathe a bit faster? We're running late for Mappa.
Hi there, Mila.
Oh, hi, guys. Perfect timing. I had a nut roll under these roots. Can you help me get it out? Pretty, please?
Mila, have you seen the size of my paws? Look, they're huge. They won't fit in there.
Mila, sorry, but Mappa is waiting for us. We'll definitely help you, but later.
The story of a hero. So today, children, I'm going to tell you the story about the Nightingale's song.
But Mappa Pandiga, nightingales again?
Can you tell us something heroic?
That's right, like about battles and stuff.
Heroic? About battles and stuff. Okay, I've got something for you. It took place a long time ago. Back then, all animals in the forest lived peacefully together. No one hurt anyone. But then, something bad happened. From a faraway land, a great pack of wolves came to the taiga. The wolves were vicious and bloodthirsty and pestered the lives of the forest residents. The animals lost their peace. They got together for a council to decide who was going to defend their home forest. But no one dared to challenge the fierce wolves. Only one animal, the strongest, fastest, and bravest of all, stood up to the wolves. The battle continued throughout the night. It was tough on our hero, but he never backed down and chased the wolves out of the forest.
Woohoo!
He really showed them wolves.
Oh, Mappa Pandiga, so who was that hero? A leopard, right?
Why would you think it's a leopard? It was a tiger for sure.
Some say it was a leopard. Some talk about a tiger. It was a long time ago. Well, children, go now, and I'm gonna have a nap.
Tig, let's play the hero game. OK, Okay, Tig. I'll be the hero, and you'll be the wolf. Go ahead, try to howl.
Howl!
No, that's not working. It doesn't sound like a wolf. It sounds like a chipmunk.
You are the chipmunk.
Tig, try to howl in here.
Wow!
Totally a wolf now!
Leo, hold on. How come I have to be the wolf? I want to be the hero.
Oh, no. The hero was a leopard.
But Mappa said that...
Mappa just didn't want to get you upset.
Maybe he didn't want you to get upset. Everyone knows that the hero was a tiger. Because tigers are stronger than leopards.
Stronger? Whatever. The leopard is agile.
No, I disagree. I play the hero or not at all.
Tig, let's make a deal. Whoever's the first to the top gets to be the hero.
Okay, you got a deal.
Hey, that's not fair!
Well, don't be so slow then. Try and catch up!
Wanna give up?
Leo,
try to keep up! Wait here. I'll be right back. I need to show Tig who the real hero is, and then I'll come back.
Mila, have you seen Leo?
Yeah, he ran that way. Tig, will you help me?
This is a bad time, Mila. I need to beat Leo first, then I'll come back. Stay where you are. Don't go anywhere.
How could I go anywhere?
Look at that! A weasel!
Poor thing got trapped! Shall we help her?
Uh-huh, yeah! And also have a lunch!
Well, who's the hero now? Huh?
Well, hero, wanna give up?
Heroes never give up! I should go first.
That's Mila! Something happened. Let's go!
Ah! Here! Take that! Ah! Shoot! How do you like that?
Stop that right now!
How about this?
Ah! Ah! This is not gonna help you anyway!
Leo!
That's fine. You are about to run out of those pine cones.
Yeah, no more pine cones.
Leave Mila alone right now, or I'll...
Oh, more food.
Come over here, my delicious...
Who did you call food, huh?
Leo, let's show them.
Grab him! Let's just throw them out of here. We already have less spicy food. Nonsense! What wolves are you talking about?
Angry and hungry.
Boss, they're here. It's definitely wolves.
All right, let's leave. It's better to stay out of their way.
You got lucky, Weasel. This time...
Leo, you have to be very careful. Wolves are coming.
It's okay, Mila. There are no wolves. It was all Tig and me.
Ooh.
Ooh. You sounded just like real wolves. I even got a little bit scared.
And here's that nut.
Thank you, guys. You know, you are my heroes.
Tig, I've got an idea. Maybe the hero that chased away the wolves wasn't alone. Maybe there were two of them?
Yeah, that's right. A tiger and a leopard. We can both be heroes. And Mila can be the wolf. Let's go play.
Hey, why me? I don't want to be the wolf.